वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आवर सेशन ऑफ एडवांस्ड फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट दैट इज IBFS. नाउ एज फार एज आर प्रीवियस सेशन वॉज कंसर्न, इन द लास्ट सेशन आई थिंक वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ आवर लीज दैट इज फाइनेंशियल लीज. द Before starting the second type, let's have a quick revision of our financial lease. Now, as compared to other lease, financial lease is a long-term lease. And when the lessor is going to transfer the right for the use of that particular asset, that will be there in the financial lease. At the end of the lease period, here lessee gets the option for the purchase of the assets, because lessee used the assets for the economic period of that particular asset. Here each and every expenditures of equipment is going to be carried by the lessee, means the person who is using the asset, because ultimately lessee is the main person who will use the whole asset for the long period of time. Now today, in today's session, we are going to discuss about operating lease. Now operating lease is totally opposite to the financial lease. Operating lease is for the short period of time, and the economic life of the asset is but obvious less than the lease period of the asset is definitely less than the economic life of the leased asset. Now let's start with the operating lease. The operating lease agreement is for a short period of time and not for economic life of the leased asset, with the option of renewing the same after the expiry of agreement. Here the renewal of lease agreement is not available to the lessee, because lessee is using the asset for the shortest period of time. Lessor provides services such as repair, maintenance attached to the leased assets. Now in operating lease, each and every expenditures of that asset is going to be carried out by the lessor, because here lessor is the responsible person of the whole asset, because lessor is not going to give the asset on lease for the longest period of time. So ultimately he is the responsible person for the use of that asset. These lease is mostly favorable to acquire asset for a short period. The operating lease is mostly for the use of office equipments, computer data processing equipments and automobiles. When the long-term use is not there and it is not advisable for the purchase of the asset, at that time operating lease is there for the use of are required asset. Now let's discuss about the features of operating lease. The first one is operating lease is for a short period compared to economic life of leased asset. suppose the economic life of the asset is 15 years, and if the time period of the lease is 7 years, so at that time that lease will be considered as operating lease. Then after, lessor does not transfer all the risk and rewards incidental to the ownership. Here, lessor is not going to transfer any ownership or any risk to the lessee, because lessee is going to use the asset for the shortest period of time. It can be cancelled. Yes, the cancellation option is available to the lessee. Here, lessee is able to cancel the whole lease agreement with the short notice. Then after, lessor is responsible for maintenance, insurance and other expenditures. Here, lessor is going to bear each and every expenditures of the leased asset. So it's all about operating lease. Now the next one, that is sales and leased back. Now this type of lease, the name itself suggests sales and leased back. Here, first and foremostly, lessor means the owner of the asset is going to sell his asset in the market and again become a lessee and take that sold asset from the purchaser on lease. So that is the sales and lease back. In a simple term, we are going to explain the whole thing. Suppose Mr. X પાસે કોઈ એક ઓફિસ ઇક્વિપમેન્ટ્સ છે કે જેની વેલ્યુ અત્યારે માર્કેટમાં 20 લેખ્સ છે. પણ મિસ્ટર એક્સને અત્યારે ફિનાન્શિયલ રિસોર્સિસની મેક્સિમમ રિક્વાયરમેન્ટ છે અને એની પાસે એટલા બધા સાઉન્ડ રિસોર્સિસ પણ નથી કે જેના થ્રુ એ પોતાની રિક્વાયરમેન્ટને સેટિસ્ફાઈડ કરી શકે. એટલે મિસ્ટર એક્સ એવું કરશે કે જે 20 લેખ્સનું એનું ઇક્વિપમેન્ટ છે એને માર્કેટમાં સેલ કરી નાખશે, એટલે એને રિટર્નમાં 20 લેખ્સ મળી જશે અને એ પોતાની ફિનાન્શિયલ નીડને એ 20 લેખ્સમાંથી સેટિસ્ફાઈ કરી નાખશે. હવે ક્વેશ્ચન થશે એ ઇક્વિપમેન્ટનો. એ ઇક્વિપમેન્ટનો યુઝ મિસ્ટર એક્સ પોતાના બિઝનેસ માટે રેગ્યુલર કરે છે અને વિધાઉટ ધ યુઝ ઓફ દેટ અસેટ મિસ્ટર એક્સ ઇઝ નોટ ગોઈંગ ટુ કેરી હિઝ ઓન બિઝનેસ. એટલે હવે મિસ્ટર એક્સ એ જે ઓફિસ ઇક્વિપમેન્ટ્સ જેને સેલ કરેલું છે એ સેમ પર્સન પાસેથી એ પોતે લીઝ ઉપર લેશે. એટલે હવે મિસ્ટર એક્સ કે જે પહેલાં ઓનર હતા, નાવ હી બીકમ ધ લેઝી ઓફ ધ અસેટ. જનરલી આ સિચ્યુએશન ત્યારે જ ફેસ કરવી પડે છે કે જ્યારે ઇમિડિયેટલી ફિનાન્શિયલ ક્રાઇસિસ ઓર્ગેનાઇઝેશન ફેસ કરે છે અને પોતે જે પણ ઇક્વિપમેન્ટ યુઝ કરે છે એ ઇક્વિપમેન્ટને સેલ કરવાથી પોતાની ફિનાન્શિયલ ક્રાઇસિસ સોર્ટ આઉટ થઈ જશે અને ફર્ધર અગેન એ જ ઇક્વિપમેન્ટ્સનો યુઝ એને પોતાના બિઝનેસને રન કરવા માટે કરવો પડશે. સો ધીસ ઇઝ ધ વન ઓફ ધ ટાઈપ ઓફ લીઝ, દેટ ઇઝ સેલ્સ એન્ડ લીઝ બેક. આ ટાઈપમાં તમારે ખાલી એનો કન્સેપ્ટ ક્લિયર કરવાનો છે. અધરવાઇઝ લીઝના બે મેઇન ટાઈપ છે કે જે ઇન્ડિયામાં અત્યારે ફેમસ છે, દેટ ઇઝ ફિનાન્શિયલ લીઝ એન્ડ ઓપરેટિંગ લીઝ. રિમેનિંગ જેટલા પણ પોઈન્ટ્સ છે ઇટ ઇઝ પોપ્યુલર ઇન ધ ફોરેન માર્કેટ. સેલ્સ એન્ડ લીઝ બેક ઇઝ અ ટાઈપ ઓફ લીઝ ઇન વિચ the owners of the asset sells his asset to lessor, and then the owner of asset sell its asset to the lessor and then gets the asset back on lease to whom it is sold. क्या एक mistake छे एक जे हाफ सेंटेंस छे बे वार रिपीट थयेलू छे. अगेन आई एम रीडिंग द होल सेंटेंस. इट इज़ अ टाइप ऑफ लीज इन विच द ओनर ऑफ द असेट सेल हिज असेट टू द लेजर एंड देन द ओनर ऑफ असेट gets the asset back on lease to whom it is sold. The firm sells asset already owned by it to another firm or company and gets the asset back on lease. So that's all about the sales and lease back. Now, the another point, that is direct lease. The name itself suggests. Here, the lessor is the manufacturer of the particular assets. Here, lessee is going to approach the manufacturing units in which the assets are manufactured, the equipments are going to be prepared. So here the owner is himself is the manufacturer of the particular asset. So this is known as direct lease, in which the lessee is going to approach the manufacturer for the lease of that particular asset. It is a lease which arranged through either the manufacturer or a financial institutions which provide direct asset to the lessee. The lessee who requires asset acquires either from the manufacturers directly to be purchased asset by leasing company. Now here, direct lease is divided into two part. The first one, that is lessee. Lease agreement with manufacturer company directly. So manufacturer act as a lessor. And second one, second lessee means lease agreement with leasing company under which manufacturer company arrange for leasing company. So here again the middle person is the leasing company who is going to meet or who going to become a center part when the manufacturing company is going to give their assets on lease directly to the lessee. So this is direct lease. Then after fifth point, that is leverage lease. Now here in leverage lease there are three parties. The first one, that is lessor, second one, that is lessee, and the third one, that is the lender, means the financial institutions who provide a financial fund to the lessor for the purchase of that particular asset. Now here lessor does not have sufficient fund for the purchase of the asset, but lessor is there in the business of lease. So here lessor is going to approach the lender. The lender means the financial institutions or the third party who provide direct fund to the lessor. Now, on the basis of that fund, Laser is going to purchase the asset and provide the same asset on lease to the lessee. So, in the leverage lease, there is an existence of three parties. Again, I am repeating, the first one is Laser, the second one is lessee, and the third one is the financial institutions which provide funds to the organization. The lessee borrows fund from the lender and also act as an equity participant. Lessee borrows major part of the purchase cost of asset from the third party, who is called lender. The asset is called mortgaged asset. Rent is paid directly to the lender by the lessee. Lessee is bound to pay the surplus amount to the third person. So that's all about the leverage lease. And the last one, that is international lease. International lease is a type of lease in which the lessee, the lessee are domiciled of different two countries. If a lease transaction cross the border with risk of currency, suppose if the lessee is from India and lessee is from the America, and if there is an agreement between these two parties, then that lease will be known as international lease. So that's all about the types of lease. As far as your examination is concerned, the type of lease is very important point, and out of the whole type, the main six type, you are going to put maximum emphasis on the first two type, that is financial lease and operating lease. Now let's have the next point, that is difference between financial lease and operating lease. The first point, in financial lease, the lessee transfer the ownership of asset at the end of lease term. In operating, the lessee does not transfer the ownership of the asset because operating lease is for the short period of time. Second point, its contract provides the option to lessee to purchase the leased asset at the end of lease contract. So the option is available to the lessee for the purchase of leased asset. Now in operating, no option to purchase the asset by the lessee, because it is for the short period of time. Then after third point, risk of the asset and reward of the asset during the economic life of the asset are transferred to lessee by the lessee. Here, each and every risk, reward, expenditures and benefits are going to be transferred by lessee to the lessee, because lessee is going to use the asset for maximum period of time. The next, in the operating lease, risk and reward of the asset is not transferred to lessee by the lessee, because here Lazy is not responsible for each and every expenditures because he is using the asset for the short period of time. The next one, financial lease is non-cancellable while operating lease is cancellable. The next one, financial lease, expenses are borne by the lessee, and in operating, expenses are borne by the lessor. The next term, the lease term is equal to the life of the asset. While in operating, the lease term is for the shorter period of time. The next point, in financial lease, along with liability for repair, lessee has to bear the risk of obsolescence of the asset or equipments. Here, lessee is going to bear each and every risk which is attached with the particular asset. Now in operating lease, lessee is not going to bear any kind of risk because at the end of the lease period, ownership is not going to transfer to him. So here, lessee is not responsible to anything. The next one, lessor recovers investment of asset along with profit during primary lease period. So lessee gets the benefit of profit which is derived by using the lease asset because he is going to use it for the long period of time. Then after, lessor does not recovers investment of asset along with profit during primary lease period because he is not using for the maximum period of time. So that's all about difference between financial and operating lease. You are supposed to prepare this point because it is really very helpful in examination. The next point, that is contents of lease agreement. Here one by one I am going to read the contents which is required at the time of preparing the lease agreement. The first one, that is details of lessor and lessee. Then after, nature of the lease. Third one, description of lease asset including estimated useful life of the equipment. Then after, time and place of equipment delivery. The next one, lease period. Then after, use of equipment by lessee. Responsibilities of lessee. Process of lease rental payment. Responsibilities for repairs and maintenance. The next one, lessor's right in case of default by the lessee. No alteration to the leased equipment without the written contents of lessor. Who is going to bear the transaction, customs, registration, delivery, clearance, charges in lease? The next one, legal responsibilities of laser. Then after lasers, right. Then after prohibition of subleasing by the lessee. And the last one, for the international lease purpose, the name of the country whose law would be applicable at the time of lease agreement. So that's all about the contents of lease agreement. Now the next point, that is advantages of leasing. The first one, that is avert risk of technological obsolescence. Yes, it is an advantage to the lessee, because if the technology is no more there in the market, so there is a no need to purchase that particular asset. So here laser is going to bear the risk of obsolescence, but as far as the operating lease is concerned, but in the financial lease, the lessee is going to bear the risk of obsolescence. So ultimately both the party gets the benefit of this technological obsolescence. The asset or the machineries which is highly technical, now it is very difficult to purchase this kind of machineries in the business, because the risk of technological obsolescence will be there. So in that point of period, the organization choose the option of lease, and they are not going to purchase the whole asset by taking the maximum risk of the obsolescence. So it is advantages to both. Then after second one, simple process. Yes, leasing is one of the simplest process ever, because you are supposed to fulfill only the formal requirements at the time of lease agreement. Otherwise, there is no difficult criterias which are going to be followed by the leasers or by the lessee. So it is one of the simplest process ever. Then after third one, that is source of finance. Now without investing anything and by paying only the lease rent, the lessee is going to enjoy the heavy equipments for the short or for the long period of time. And again, lessee gets the benefit of the lease rent. So leasing, the process of leasing will give the maximum benefits to lessee and lessee both. So it is one of the biggest source of finance which gives the benefit as a lease rent to the lessee, and benefit of using the heavy machineries with the handsome amount by paying a nominal lease rent. Then after the next one, that is less costly. Leasing as financing is less expensive as compared to purchase of the whole equipments from the financial institutions, because you are just going to pay the lease rent and some other formality or some other cost by entering in the agreement with the leaser or lessee. So it is one of the less costly procedure. The next one is suitable for short term. Yes, with the help of operating lease option, the organization or the lessee enjoy the asset for the shortest period of time and fulfill their financial requirement for not purchasing the particular asset. Then after, tax benefit. Yes, as we all know that lease rentals are tax deductible for the lessee, and lessor also gets the benefit in depreciation. So ultimately it is gives the tax benefit, or it provides the tax advantages to both lessors and the lessee. Then after, the next point, that is protection of lessor. Yes, by entering in a formal agreement with the lessee, here the risk, the interest of the lessor can be easily protected. The next one is flexibility of lease rentals. Yes, as we all know that there is no change in the lease rent once it is decided in the lease agreement. So it is possible for a lessee, that is to keep a regular control over the future cash flow. And the last advantage is without down payment. Here lessee is not going to purchase the asset. He is just paying the lease rent and enjoy the costly machineries or assets by paying a simple lease rent. Here lessee is not going to pay any amount of or any amount by paying the down payments for the purchase of any assets. So these are the main advantages of leasing. Now we'll discuss the limitations of leasing. The first one, that is restriction. Yes, due to the nature of the asset, there are some restriction on the use of that leased assets. The second one, ownership lies with the lessor. Here, lessor is not going to transfer the ownership, but he simply transfer the the use or the right of use of that particular asset. So as far as the financial lease is concerned, now it is up to the lessee that he is going to decide for the purchase of that asset or not. So ultimately here lessee gets the maximum benefit if the financial lease is concerned. Then after, the next limitation is consequence of default. Sometimes there are defaults in the payment of the lease rental. So at that time, lessee face the heavy loss, because lessee is not going to pay a regular rent to the lessor, and ultimately with the legal force the lessor gets the possession back of his lease asset from the lessee. The next one, that is residual value. Here lessee is the owner of the leased asset up to the period of particular residual value of the asset. Now suppose if the terminal value of asset of any fixed asset is very high, but the lessee is deprived of the residual value. So ultimately lessee, the owner of the asset, does not get the benefits of residual value of that asset in a proper manner. The last one is prohibition of alteration. Now here lessee is prohibited to make alteration or improvement on leased asset without the prior permission of the lessee. So ultimately sometimes it is very difficult to continue with the same asset without making alteration in the asset which the lessee has. So these are the limitations of leasing. So today we are going to end our chapter itself, that is leasing. Now as far as the practical terms of the lease are concerned, it is not important in your examination, because it clearly mentioned that in examination the practical terms are excluded. So here we are putting focus on the theory part of the leasing, that is types of lease and other points. So that's all about today's session, and here our chapter 1 of unit number 3 is completed. In the next session we are going to start the new chapter, that is higher purchase, and we are going to see what is higher purchase and what is the basic difference between leasing and higher purchase. So that's all for today. थैंक यू सो मच.